Yeah, so thank you, Isa. And this presentation makes part of my PhD thesis, and it deals with the historical phenomenon of Urnfield culture. The main evidence of Urnfield culture is the spatiotemporal distribution of cremation burials. And in this presentation, we managed to quantify such phenomenon, and we also try to quantify other phenomena that have been partially associated to cremation burials. For instance, the distribution in space and in time of fluted pottery and other typologies, metallic and ceramic as well. Therefore, since we want to quantify this phenomena, we need to quantify the concept of time. And we started collecting a huge amount of data of radiocarbon dates and associated archaeological contexts in a large region from the Danube to the Ebro River. And we collected such data in a database that will be soon available, and it's called the EUBAR database. So the geographic framework includes a large area from the Danube to the Ebro River, and the analyzed time span goes from 1800 BC to 750 BC. We decided to take into account 750 as the last term, basically due to the presence in the calibration curve of the so-called Hallstatt plateau, and therefore radiocarbon dates in this time span would be characterized by a too large standard deviation and a high degree of uncertainty. The starting point has been to associate his isotopic event into palimpsest structures in order to detect the social event, that is basically the result of social actions recorded in the archaeological deposits. It's quite clear that in order to understand a specific social action, we need a large amount of radiocarbon dates, and we need to model these radiocarbon dates using different techniques. Nowadays, a quite fashionable topic is the use of radiocarbon dates in order to produce some calibrated probability distribution and to analyze the demographic intensity in the past. There is a recently published publication of Sheenan and his team who analyzed the neolithization of Europe, and they managed to describe a boom and bust pattern for the diffusion of Neolithic. But what about the Bronze Age, which is the period we want to study and to present in this in this conference? Well, actually, there are two main models. The first one has been proposed by Christiansen, who managed to identify the Urnfield culture as a period of a high demographic intensity. And to the same conclusion arrived at Zimmermann in his work, who identified a high degree of population and density exactly corresponding to the Urnfield culture, therefore to the Late Bronze Age. So we decided to test this hypothesis using data collected in EUBAR database, and we produced a summit calibrated probability distribution including 1897 radiocarbon dates, and we can see a quite flat shape with two small peaks. Well, actually peaks should be interpreted as period of higher intensity. But simulating the same number of radiocarbon dates distributed in a random way in the same time span, we can see a quite similar pattern. Indeed, if we check the calibration curve, around 100 and 150 and 800, we have two H time steps. Therefore, these peaks should be interpreted as a consequence of the process of calibration better than a consequence of a high demographic signal. Then we decided to go deeper in our analysis, taking into account separately residential area, settlements, and funerary contexts. On the one hand, we have a slight increase in the amount of settlement, but this increase could be interpreted also as a phenomenon of post-depositional effect. But on the contrary, for funerary contexts, the pattern is completely different because we have a decrease and then an increase. But in this case, we cannot refer to this analysis as a proxy for demographic intensity, but as a phenomenon of adoption of two different ritual, cremation and inhumation. And then I will focus better in this part. And it's quite interesting to note that our results are in agreement with what has been recently published by Armit and his team on analyzing Irish context. And what about a regional scale? Because now we have analyzed the whole amount of data from the Danube to the Ebro River, but if we take into account a more regional scale, we can detect different patterns in different regions, and it's quite meaningful, for instance, in the Padan Plain, in this part, where we can see a decrease in the number of radiocarbon dates, and if we check it also with archaeological information, we know that we have a lack in the presence of archaeological sites in the southern part of the Padan Plain, starting from the Late Bronze Age. Well, then we decided to follow using the same methodology, but applied not only to analyzing demographic signal, but also to the analysis of phenomena of adoption of innovation across time. We started with the funerary ritual, which is the main objective of this presentation. And on the one hand, we analyzed contexts with radiocarbon dates recovered in association with inhumation burials. And on the other hand, we have summed the radiocarbon dates of contexts associated to cremation burials. Well, we can clearly see how different is the pattern in the phase. First case, we have a decrease of the number of inhumation in time, and this decrease is also shown by the histogram of medians of radiocarbon dates. On the contrary, for cremation burials, we have an increase in time. Therefore, we can argue that cremation burial in our region, from the Ebro to the Danube River, is a clearly phenomenon of adoption of innovation during the Bronze Age. And on a macro scale, we could locate the transition around, well, it's a simple model in this way, around 1200 BC. But on a regional scale, the situation is quite different because we can see that the phenomenon took place before in the North Alpine regions. Here we have some radiocarbon dates located in this area. And the queue, let's say, of the phenomena should be located in the northeastern part of the Iberian Peninsula. And also a similar pattern can be detected in southern France. But in this presentation, we wanted also to model other features that are frequently associated to cremation burials, in particular fluted pottery. And also in this case, we can see an increase in the number of contexts that produce radiocarbon dates. And on a regional scale, also in this case, we have different patterns in different regions. Then the pattern is quite similar to the pattern of cremation burials, with the most recent radiocarbon dated archaeological context located in the northeastern part of the Iberian Peninsula. Then we analyzed also other variables like pottery with handle with vertical expansion, and well, it's a specific kind of pottery characterized by this characteristic handle. And also in this case, we have an adoption, but the adoption is followed by a decrease in time, and also in different area. Well, regrettably, in this case, we do not have a lot of data, so we would like to fill the gaps with new data in the future. And also for metallic typology, we have taken into account daggers, so radiocarbon dated contexts with daggers, and metal knives. In the first case, we have a decrease of the amount of daggers in times, and in the second case, we have the innovation, which is represented by the introduction, the development, and the spread of metal knives along space and across time. Well, now we have just taken a look to this summer calibrated distribution in order to understand the adoption of innovation, but we wanted to test our results. So we decided to use the available literature, and in particular Roger's model for adoption of innovation, in which we have the role of innovators at the beginning, then we have an exponential increase in the adoption, and then the system, which is his carrying capacity, which corresponds to a period in which no more people adopt the innovation. Therefore, we fitted the generalized distribution, logistic distribution, to the result of some calibrated probability distributions. And our result stresses that we have a quite high value, around 1, for the coefficient of determination, for cremation burials, for fluted pottery, and for metal knives. On the contrary, for vessel we had with handle with vertical expansion, the value was low. In fact, we have an increase and then a decrease in time of this variable. But, well, we have analyzed this innovation, this phenomena, both in time, but also in space. Therefore, we used the wave of advance model, which was used basically for describing the velocization in Europe, but it could be also applied not only to demodynamic diffusion, but also to cultural transmission and to phenomena of adoption of innovation as well. And it's important that in order to detect an expansive phenomena, we need to recognize in our data a spatiotemporal gradient. It means a certain degree of dependence between location. And this degree of dependence is what gives us a unity to the phenomenon. And the Tabler law should be accomplished. So we started analyzing cremation burials. We plotted the first occurrence of cremation burials in the analyzed regions, and we interpolated our results using medians of radiocarbon dates. And the obtained results stress that the phenomenon took place earlier in the Alpine regions, which correspond to the western part of Switzerland and west northwestern part of Italy. And then we have a clearly east to west spatiotemporal gradient, and the phenomenon is characterized by a more recent chronology in Catalonia, for instance, and in central Italy as well. And then there is also another focus with a quite old cremation burial, which is located in the most eastern part. So the pattern apparently is quite complex. This is just a simple model, and we want to go deeper in our results. And there are also lack of radiocarbon dates here in this region for southern France. So we decided to fill this lack using the result of variation models for southern France and northern Italy that have been recently published. Therefore, we have taken into account the typological dates produced by the typological analysis of some cremation burials located in this area, and we have used radiocarbon dates produced by the Bayesian models. And also adding this amount of data in our model, we can also see the east to west pattern, so the situation does not change a lot. And it's interesting that the spatiotemporal gradient could be represented also by arrows, which points according to the ratio of diffusion. It means from places where it took place before towards places where innovation taken place, well, toward places where the innovation is characterized by a more recent chronology. And it's interesting that, for instance, in Catalonia, we could argue an introduction of cremation burial towards maritime contacts and not through the Pyrenees, for instance. Then we decided to use also other variables included in the database and associated to radiocarbon dates. Previously, we saw that we could distinguish different patterns in different regions for the distribution of handles with vertical expansion. And if we plot the first occurrence of the phenomenon, also in this case, there is an east to west pattern where the oldest contexts are located in the northern Italy and the more recent in the Catalan coast. Of course, yeah, well, in this case, we don't have a lot of data, so we could add, but it's quite interesting that in this case we have this nucleus along the Ebro Valley, so maybe the introduction is not through maritime coast, but through the Pyrenees. And we have represented the same analysis using using arrows. So, the conclusion of our work. Well, instead of presenting conclusion, we would like to end with an open question. We know from historic sources that there is, in the Iron Age, the development and the spread of Celtic languages in Europe. And we ask if the diffusion of Celtic language could be somehow related to the diffusion that took place at the end of Bronze Age, for instance, the diffusion of cremation burials. Well, actually, there are different theories. The first one locates the origin of the Celtic people and Celtic languages as well in the Alpine region. And then from this area, they could have moved toward Western territories. But another theory is Celtic from the West. And in this case, the origin should be placed in the Atlantic coast. Well, in our case, for the Bronze Age and for the Late Bronze Age, we have been able to detect only east to west facial temporal pattern. Therefore, we cannot stress any kind of movement from the west to the east. And we have talked about population dynamics, and in order to understand the causes that pushed this movement of adaptation, of innovation, of people, of an idea. We have talked about the adoption of foreign ideas, social influence theory, but maybe we should analyze better the process of standardization in terms of the formulation of a cultural consensus that allowed to this innovation to spread in time, thanks to the connection between neighboring peoples and neighboring regions as well. Thank you. Thank you.